All right, so there's a good close-up of that bracket. You can see how it has a center journal that fits inside the center T-slot right here, like that. And so that helps keep it aligned left to right on this extrusion. And again, this is assuming the extrusion is true and it's straight and it's flat along its length. The back one has the same thing. And the front one is actually not, the front bearing motor mount is actually not as wide as the back one. So that added to some complexity to making those adapter plates. But once I got those things made and hooked it up, originally they were plastic. So not that these are anything special, because they're not, because it's a very simple part. It's just a recess for this guy to fit into. And then I shaved it down and left basically a key that would slide in this middle slot and use it as a long keyway to make sure it's keeping everything centered. So it's nothing special by any means, but these used to be plastic, so that's why I'm kind of singing their praises, because they definitely helped with the alignment issues. All right, so I just got done milling that bracket down. And even though this Harbor Freight mini mill can be quite the pain sometimes, I did hop it up with the pulley system, which makes it a ton quieter. It just runs a lot smoother because of the plastic gears. I don't have to deal with that with the belt drive. That was a pretty trick. Got that from a little machine shop. Anyway, so the bracket did look like this on both sides. So I basically took off a quarter of an inch on this end. So the bracket mounts to the 80-20 like this, and then the actuator is laying across the top of it. So that gains me a quarter of an inch. Will that be enough? Not real sure yet. Part two of this issue was the width of the T-nuts. These are 1 inch. So I looked through my little bag of tricks, and I found one. These are the heavy-duty T-nuts, I believe is what they're called. And they're made out of steel. That's a quarter 20 thread inside there. And luckily enough, this lines up perfectly with the hole, and you've got two different sides. I don't know if this was supposed to be drilled in the center. This one happens to be offset, which works to my advantage in this one. If I go order some off eBay tomorrow, they might be different. I'm not sure, but if need be, I can cut those down as well. So if I use these heavy duty T-nuts on this bracket and this bracket, then I should be able to close that gap and shift everything to the rear of the machine by at least a quarter of an inch, if not more. So we'll have to see if that's going to give me enough clearance here to put that bracket in. So we'll just have to wait and see. I think I'll go ahead and order those T-nuts probably tonight, and I've got some other extrusion I was wanting to pick up at the same time, so it's no big deal. So as for now, I'm going to leave the Y-axis alone, and I will start taking the motors off of the X and the Z. So here we go.